first jumper of your United States Army Golden Knights. This is Arlen Slate from Vancouver, British Columbia, and he is carrying the Boy Scouts flag for us this afternoon. To his credit. Jumping with the Daniel Webster Boy Scouts flag. You can see that.
Working their arms and legs to form the nucleus of the formation. Remaining jumpers set up slightly above and outside, awaiting the team leader's call. At 9,000 feet, the team leader waves his arms, signaling the outside flyers to fly to the base, using their hands, arms, legs, and shoulders as flight controls, allowing them to safely complete the formation. The free fall photographer circles them as the formation continues to fly at 120 miles per hour. At 5,000 feet, the team leader waves his arms, signaling the outside flyers to perform our bomb burst maneuver. Working off the same set of signals, the jumpers in the base deploy their parachutes, and there you have the high-flying black and gold of your United States Army parachute team, the Golden Knights. Now, as you may have guessed, these jumpers are placed with a unique situation, a traffic jam in the sky. They must gain vertical separation to allow for individual approaches into the target area. Once the jumpers set up that traffic vector, they will fly a downwind blade, a base blade 90 degrees to the target, then set up for their final approach facing into the wing. It takes a great deal of concentration to land dead center of the target. Ladies and gentlemen, at this altitude, the jumpers can hear you, so make some noise. You may see the amount of directions that the jumper makes in order to set up his approach for a dead center landing. For his final approach, ladies and gentlemen. There's the setup. He shuts it down for a beautiful dead center landing. Ladies and gentlemen, the parachute that you see that is more black than gold is our Army Star Canopy. This is a unique parachute that was designed for this show season. Assistant team leader shuts down right over the target for a dead center landing. Our team leader, some of his last Will Fleming, is flying in our team flag. He's setting up first. Here he comes, ladies and gentlemen, shutting it down. Dead center landing. Ladies and gentlemen, direct your attention overhead. It would appear that these two canopies have become entangled. However, that is not the case. These two jumpers are performing a facet of the sport called canopy relative work. With the advanced modern design of these ram air parachutes, it is actually possible to fly one canopy into the hands of another jumper. Ladies and gentlemen, if you thought landing one canopy was hard, watch as these jumpers bring in the two stack into the target area. You may hear the command ready break just prior to them separating. There you have one. The Golden Knights in free fall from Los Angeles, California. He is an airborne ranger with 5,974 free fall parachute jumps. Sergeant First Class Will Fleming. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to introduce my demonstration team for the 2010 air show season.
all members of your United States Army Parachute Team, the Golden Knights.
On behalf of the entire team, I would like to thank each and every one of you for being such a warm and receptive airport audience. In closing, I leave you with this final thought. In the future, may all of your days be prosperous and your nights golden.